there. Thanks for joining me for Bible journaling. Today, we're going to be working in our A Moment to Breathe 365 devotions, and we are currently on day 241, The Difference That Makes All the Difference by Renee Swope. So our verse today is in Ephesians 4, 1 through 3. Therefore, I, the prisoner in the Lord, urge you to live worthy of the calling you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience bearing with one another in love, making every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace. One morning I was working from home alone. The house was quiet and I was feeling all kinds of productive. That week marked the final stretch of a big project, and I had planned a fun family dinner and a game night. Life was peachy, and I felt like such a good mom. Then my kids came home from grandma's house earlier than planned, and one of them did something that was not so peachy. A few minutes later, my other child did not do something I asked him to do. All of a sudden, I lost my peace and patience right in the middle of the kitchen. Our family dinner and game night didn't go so well. Later that night, as I tried to fall asleep, a regret-filled soundtrack of harsh words replayed in my head. Guilt convinced me I was a terrible, horrible, no good parent who had permanently damaged my kids' emotional well-being. Shame pointed its finger in my face and told me I was the worst mom on earth. In the past, I would have shook hands with shame and agreed with guilt, but something was different this time. I had come to know the difference between conviction and condemnation. Condemnation comes with cruel, broad, sweeping statements. You're so hypocritical, Renee. You are never going to change. But God's conviction is specific and points me toward love and relational repair. Your words were harsh, Renee. All you need to do is apologize and ask for forgiveness. Condemnation says we'll never change, but godly conviction shows us how we can. The next morning, I apologized to my kids and asked them to forgive me for losing my patience with them the day before. And we did a makeup date for our failed family game night. I'm so grateful for grace that convicts me and helps me put back the pieces of my broken attempts to be humble, gentle, kind, and patient and kind. So our moment to breathe today says, thank the Father for the loving conviction He brings and the sweet gift of His grace. Doesn't that sound wonderful? So Ephesians today, let's turn to that. It was Ephesians 4, 1 through 3. So, Ephesians is a very popular section because I've already done that page and we've done a tip-in in here. So, what I did is I went ahead and I grabbed my little phone out and I Googled it. And I did a Google search for the word patience or peace. And it gave me a bunch of little pictures and some verses that I could use instead. So, I have decided to do Numbers, chapter 6, verse 26. And it says, the Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. I thought that was pretty appropriate because when I started my verse today, I was going to print out an image and I was going to color it onto a piece of sticker paper and then stick it in my Bible. And every time that I turned the camera on, Lexi came in to interrupt me and and ask questions, or the dog was in here, so she was torturing the dog, and I turned the camera on and off more times than I could get the thing even halfway colored, and I finally just gave up on that. And now she has decided that she would love a bubble bath. So she is currently laying in the bubble bath, and she said that she would be good for the 10 minutes that she would give me to read my story and put some stickers in my Bible and do today's verse. So God is granting me some peace on doing today's verse. So I headed over to the paper shelter. This was the cute little image that I was going to color, but when you buy this, you get a colored one too. So I went ahead and I just printed her out on some sticker paper, and she's all colored and ready to be stuck in there. And doesn't she look beautiful? And then I also went, and I'd already printed these out, was planning on using them anyway, but these are from Illustrated Face Print and Pray Shop, and they are by Amy Bruce. And I couldn't find them in the shop anymore, so they must be retired, but this was I Fall for Jesus little set. So maybe if you contact her, she will sell you one, or maybe put it back in the store, I'm not sure. But let's go ahead and get started, because remember, I have a whole maybe 10 minutes that Lexi has decided I may do something quietly. And of course I can't find my pen. Let's see here if I can find another pen. Because I wasn't thinking that far ahead. So I'm going to go ahead and underline my verse. God is granting me some peace that it's fine that I don't have an hour to mess around. I have a bubble bath. That's what I get. So I'm going to go ahead and stick my sticker in here. And I want to make sure that my girl is not sitting on top of my verse, but I also want to make sure her chair is straight. So it's going to go off the page a little bit. And I did reduce this to 75% of the original size. Look how pretty she looks. You just peel her off and stick her right in there. So that is sometimes how life works. You do not get what you want. But that's the way it works. And God said that was fine, that I would not get what I want. And you guys would be fine with doing some stickers today and just doing a little bit of Bible journaling. So I'm going to go ahead and I think I'm going to put this little strip up here, not this big of a piece. But this says, "You are my shelter in the storm." And I feel like I'm needing some shelter in a storm today. So let's go with this and maybe cut it off over here past the blue. And I'm thinking I'm just going to stick this like so, maybe down in here. And I printed this also on some sticker paper, but it was white. So that's also an option if you're doing sticker paper. Okay, so I'm gonna go, how about right about here? And then we are going to put this on. And this I did print out on some clear sticker paper. So I'm going to go ahead and stick the shelter over the top of the pink parts. I probably could have printed it on some white paper so that it would be a little bit darker, but I'm okay. I didn't have it printed out on white paper. So that is what we're going to use, is what we got. Remember, short on time today. And then let's put these little hearts on here. This was also part of the stickers, or part of that little Fall for Jesus set. It has some really cute fall theme stuff on there. Oh, come off of there. Of course, the sticker paper has to give me grief. So I'll go ahead and put this. Since there's words, I'm gonna go ahead and put my yellow one right here so you can see it really good, because the other two are darker. And I think it works out perfect that they kind of go with her outfit. She's wearing pink and an aqua color. And look, this one's aqua, and we got some aqua up here in this. So I guess God was ahead of me when he let me find this little sheet here of stuff before I got started. He's like, "Heather, it's not gonna work out the way you think. So you might as well just live with it and make it work." I think I'll go, I wanna have this up here. I think I'll go right here. I didn't even prep my page today. That's how completely with it I am. And then we got this little piece. Do we wanna put this down here? No. I think I'm gonna go with that. So we're gonna go ahead and we're going to write our journaling. And I'm thinking maybe I'm gonna switch pins because this one didn't work very well. So let me get out this new packet. Some of them don't do very well after you do the gesso on there. So, oh yeah, see, this one's working a lot better. Re-underline that a little bit. So we go up here, we'll do some journaling. So my journaling today says, thank you for showing me the way to today, for not letting me lose my temper and be upset by a change of plans, for showing me it can work out. And then I always finish up with my date down here so I know what day I'm working on that. So anyway, I hope you had fun doing Bible journaling today. It was quick and easy. I hope you'll give it a try yourself. If you have a question, leave me a comment down below and I'll make sure to get back to you. Don't forget to hit the like button down in the corner if you like the video, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already so you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video. I hope you're having a fabulous day, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.